Hey, this is Manuel from Zeal and Ardor, and you're getting your fix of metal injection. Hey, this is Manuel from Zeal and Ardor. I'm in New York City, and we're going to talk about some brutalist architecture. Brutalist architecture is a type of building the houses, as the professionals call it, which involves lack of windows, exposed concrete, and big monuments. It's very popular. Was very popular in, I want to say, 30 to 40s Germany, France. There was a little time that was also popular here in the States, but the Soviets really lapped that shit up and brought us these huge, humongous UFO-looking structures that just kind of speak to me in a weird way. We're at the Guggenheim Museum. This is actually one of the city's more renowned brutalist sites. Although, strictly said, it's not really brutalist architecture, since the word brutalism was derived from bru, which means nude. Concrete bru, béton bru in French means exposed concrete, which this is not. But in terms of how to build things, the foundation was just concrete. And the lack of windows and the big spacious blocks of concrete are big indicators of brutalist architecture. I started liking this stuff because it's not very popular by anyone really, and these huge buildings tend to be in total disarray, and there's like stuff growing on them, and there's this odd romantic vibe of something dead but still huge and standing that I love. This is the Ford Foundation building. Kevin Roche built this structure in 1963. It's not strictly brutalism, but a postmodernist vision. He incorporated a lot of concrete, a lot of ugly elements, just to ensure the structural integrity of the building, in spite of the trends of postmodern, what was it called, perfectionism of the New York Five. He did his thing, and I can appreciate that. The best piece of brutalist architecture I saw was the Trellick Tower in London, which is just this phallic structure next to like a cube. It just looks otherworldly and also disheveled. We're in front of the Kips Bay Plaza, a building that just oozes sadness and despair. Kind of looks like Bratislava, like you mentioned before. 20 stories high, but much, much sadder than that. Love it. What speaks to me is that every single window is actually alive, but it's such an insignificant part of such a huge, huge structure that it doesn't seem like it's worth anything. And I find that sad and just kind of cool, I'm afraid. I think looking at these buildings kind of strikes a similar chord like the one I hear or feel while making music, because there's this weird emotional response to basically nothing, and it kind of urges you to create something. This is the Fashion Institute of Technology on 7th Avenue. It was designed by De Jong, Moskowitz, and Rosenberg in 59 and erected shortly thereafter. This building communicates, humans are not important, I'll be here forever, and I don't care about you, which are sentiments I can really subscribe to. I think if Devil Is Fine would be a building, it wouldn't be a brutalist structure. I think it would be this old southern mansion with a lot of music boxes and a weird odor. Thanks for letting me bore you with disgusting architecture today. If you are still bored, you can check out my new album, Devil Is Fine. Thanks.